Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about why I'm very excited about Flutter. Alright, so today I want to talk just a little bit about Flutter because one of the questions I get asked a lot in the live streams or via email or chat is, hey Eric, what do you think about Flutter? Or, you know, what do you think about Flutter versus React Native? And my answer is always the same. I'm very excited about it. I probably talked about it on this channel on one of the daily videos before that it is something that excites me, right? But I never go into detail about why I like it. In fact, it's the one language that when I do have a bit of free time, and it seems like the free time is shrinking a lot of the times because we got so much client work on, we got so many projects going on that when I do have a bit of free time, I'm doing the tutorials and trying to learn the Flutter side of things because I think it's the way forward for mobile. I really do. I think it's going to replace a lot of the Cordova-based applications that we're using. I think it's even going to replace React Native personally, but you can't be sure. So there's some things that I really like about it. So I made a list so that I could be a bit more specific because I'd rather say, oh, I think it's going to be really cool. So the first one is this cross-platform. See, cross-platform is nothing new. You've got Xamarin, you've got React Native, you've got Cordova and Ionic. So that's nothing new, but every single one of those lacks something to me, right? There was always some reason why, oh, it's great because it's cross-platform, we could go to both platforms, but there's always that but. Like with Xamarin, you still have to do the WYSIWYG editors for iOS or for Java. You still have to do that kind of stuff. You have to kind of know how Java, or how the Android platforms work and the iOS platforms work in order to do it, at least in my experience. If you're a Xamarin developer and you disagree with me, by all means. By the way, this is all opinion. This is what I think, why I'm excited about Flutter. So there's that. People will ask what I thought about Kotlin, right, when Kotlin came out. And the thing about Kotlin was it didn't solve any problems for me. I didn't have a problem using Java for native Android development. So Kotlin came along and I wasn't really that interested. But with Flutter coming in as a replacement to something like React Native or Ionic, that's something that interests me because I still have those problems. React Native is probably the close second to Flutter for me. However, I get into this dependency hell where you're trying to, seems like every time I'm trying to compile something, something has changed and I'm going through and trying to change my NPM settings. There's some dependency, some other library that's changed, and I haven't found that so far in Flutter, and maybe that's the case. The second thing I really like about it is there's no WYSIWYG editor, right? There's nothing that it just, you code, it renders on the screen and it just refreshes like that. They're not trying to dumb it down by including a drag and drop XML interface or anything like that. It's just code. So you go through and as you do it, you see that immediate feedback and do that. And I really like doing that. I like doing that in when we're doing web development. I like doing it all throughout the place just because you have a little bit more control over it. But it might be daunting to somebody just starting to not be able to just see everything and drag it on there. And you can't divide up that work if you wanted to. So theoretically, you can give the XML Java files to a designer and they could work on, but I've never found that to be a very easy thing to do. So the second one is it's very fast to load. It's very fast to load, specifically on a device, because we do a lot of Ionic development, or we used to do a lot of Ionic development. And the thing I loved about Ionic is the having it in a browser and you just get that immediate feedback. If you go from native to Ionic and you notice how quick that is, it's a complete game changer because you just get that fast feedback. But the thing about Ionic is it runs into WebView, and that's something that I've just never really been comfortable with. So you're getting the same thing with Flutter because you're making these changes and you're running it not necessarily, you can run it in an emulator, but you could do it on a device too, and you get that hot reload thing. And again, an Ionic, that hot reload thing, for me, it always seemed to break every so often. There's always a new version, something comes out, there's breaking changes, I got another library, some dependency somewhere I need to change, and that's, you know, that's something. The fourth thing that I really like about Flutter is the dependency hell. I haven't noticed that yet. And it's still in beta, so, you know, it hasn't had all that many updates yet, but, we do a lot of React Native development now. We used to do a lot of Ionic and Cordova development, and it seems like every time the developers would work on something, I would get the code from Git, I would try to run it locally, and I don't have some sort of libraries, and I gotta keep going through. And even though it's specified in the package.json, there's some other dependency somewhere, and it seems like we spend so much time just trying to reconcile our development builds between developers that it just, it kills me. Or there's a change coming through and you're wondering, should we upgrade to this new version? What will it break in terms of our legacy applications? And we spend so much time dealing with things that are broken that it's just, it's hell. It's hell, dependency hell. The last thing is just the excitement about it. Yesterday there was a Flutter conference. It was streamed. Now I'm filming this before this, so I haven't seen it, but we do see Google especially, even though it's an open, you know, they're open sourcing it, there you see Google with a lot of energy behind it. And that's a good thing. That means I started to think, because Google is Android, you think there would be a lot of interdependency between them. Even if iOS for some reason had an issue with it, we do see the Android market share being 80%. And I think I just have a lot more trust in that, the fact that there's so much energy behind it, so much enthusiasm, and they have the budget to really take this far away. So that's everything. Those are the five reasons, the five big reasons why I'm excited about Flutter. Now there's some other things that I do find a bit worrying, just in terms of taking on a project. The first one is in beta. So I do find issues when even just doing the minimal bit of coding that I've been doing on it, that just things don't work right, and I have to keep restarting. Android Studio, or restarting the emulators, or you know, switching off the device and things like that. But I think these are minor teething issues. Like I said, it's still in beta. Hopefully, it won't be in beta forever. But it is. The second thing that I'm not quite sure about is it uses Dart as a language. Now, Dart is syntactically, I find it very syntactically similar to JavaScript and Java and all the other curly bracket languages. You got the curly brackets, you got the semicolons, all that kind of stuff. So that's cool. However, I don't have any other uses for Dart yet. If I do something in JavaScript, I can use JavaScript everywhere, right? If I do Java, I can use it in more than one place. But with Dart, I just have that. So it's learning that new language, which it doesn't seem to be too difficult to pick up. But it's something that it's not as portable yet as I hope to. I know they're talking about Dart being this big language and everything, and it is compiled, so it should be faster than JavaScript, but you know, it is what it is. And the last one here, the last thing that I'm skeptical about when we come to doing Dart development is, or doing Flutter development, is if PWAs take off, we can't reuse that code to do a progressive web app. Or if we have a client that says, okay, now we want a website, we can't reuse any of that code because it's in Dart. So we're committed fully to the app platform. And also, because it is so new, I find it very difficult finding developers who know Dart. I mean, developer who wants a job as a software developer, they're looking for the largest number of jobs that are available. And right now, there's not a lot of companies looking for Flutter development. It's more people who are learning Flutter are interested in doing their own things, not so much people looking for a job. So it's really hard to find Flutter developers, at least in my experience so far. So that's just me. That's entirely opinion. I just want to let you guys know. So the next time we have that question, what do you think about Flutter? That's what I think about Flutter. I'm very excited about it. I think it's going to be big going forward. You know, I'm more sure about Flutter than I am about progressive web apps. Progressive web apps, we said it on the last live stream, that I'm afraid it's going to be like the mini discs of software development, where everybody, all the technical people are telling you how much better it is, but for whatever reason, the mass public is not picking it up, right? That's what I'm afraid about with progressive web apps. And again, I could be wrong, so I'm really excited about Flutter. I'm really hoping that in the next 6 months, we move most of our stuff, or most of our newer projects, into Flutter and out of some of the current platforms that we're using. So let me know what you guys think. I'd be really interested, as for those of you guys out there who are software developers, especially if you're using Flutter, what do you think about it? I mean, what do you like about it and what do you dislike about it? If you're not touching it, why are you not touching it? If you're jumping full on into it, what excites you about it? I'd really love to hear that. Anyway, that is it for today. This was a very long one. Sorry, that is it for today. I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow.